According to Dale Gracious Puwata, the founder of the rehabilitation home, all children have a right to proper care, education and basic needs. This includes disabled children. To facilitate the well-being of disabled children, Puwata says the rehabilitation center will help shelter the abandoned children and also provide them with survival skills. The center will also teach parents on how to take care of special needs children.
I decided to put up a demo home. This is a demo home for them to make sure that we can teach their families on how they can care for their children. We can teach the community on how they can support children with disabilities.
Amari Faith Josephine explains how she was unable to complete her education since she had to devote all her time looking after her disabled child. She explains why the center is a ray of hope to many mothers like her.
After completing my S4, I had a desire to continue with schooling, to go in HSC level. But my mom told me that I will not manage to go back because she was not going to be there at home. I have to stay with the child.
These abandoned children are leaders for tomorrow. These are children for the nation. These are our own children. And people shouldn't look at that someone's disability. If these children are given education, if they are supported, they can also perform like any other child.
Some of his children have shared their painful stories and experiences and the stigma they have been through. Willy Nkumbi, the Kalangala District Senior Probation Officer, confirmed that many special needs children are locked in houses, all abandoned to elders in villages, yet others are rejected by communities. Many parents have abandoned the responsibility of taking care of their children, mainly those with special needs, because they don't want them to associate with others and also don't want the community to know about them. He has, on behalf of the district, pledged total support towards the daily running of his home. Currently, 17 children are under care and different people and organizations have donated different materials including clothes, scholastic materials and food supplies, as well as other materials to be used. Story by Samuel Nkuba for the news in Kalangala District.